Welcome to Speaker Mastermind. Your specialist subject is?
Small loudspeakers.
Your first compact loudspeakers were?
Wharfdale Diamond 3s.
Your eldest speakers were?
Celestian Ditton 10 15 ohm 1964. Actually, the first...
Shut up, nobody cares.
Okay.
Your favourite compact speakers are?
That would be Celestian A Compacts, designed by Bob Smith.
Shut up, nobody cares.
What?
Currently reviewing now?
Alchris Audio AR-2s.
Correct.
Hello and welcome to the Dittonworks YouTube channel, where today I'm going to review the Alchris Audio AR-2 loudspeakers. Compact two-way loudspeakers are an absolute favourite of mine. So in the little joke section at the beginning there, my very first compact two-way loudspeakers were the Wharfdale Diamond 3s. And I'd gone from Wharfdale Dovedale 3s all the way down to Diamond 3s. And when I brought them home, I thought, these are just going to be pants. They're not going to be any good. I've gone from enormous speakers down to really tiny speakers. And after a while, I realised that actually there was something quite special about a mini monitor. The way they imaged, the way the driver integration worked, the surprising bass response you could get from this very, very small box. Move forward in time a bit and I got the A Compacts, which again were very impressive for a two-way small compact monitor. So when I had the chance to review these, Alchris Audio AR-2s, which definitely fall into that compact two-way mini monitor, I just thought, I've got to have a listen to these. So I messaged Alan Clark at Alchris Audio and said, I've got no new loudspeakers to review. Would you mind if I borrowed the AR-2s, which he gladly said he would send down to me. And I thought, let's have a listen. So a few weeks ago, probably a month or two ago actually, I reviewed the AR-6s, which are two up in the range. So it goes AR-2, AR-4, AR-6, AR-8, AR-10, and then the huge AR-66s. Now, everything apart from those features this same design of able to remove the grill cloth and attach it round the side of the cabinet. Now, this, I thought this was an incredibly clever idea because A, it solves the problem of storage. Where do you put the grills when you're not using them? And B, when you move them round to the side and stick them on the cabinet with the hidden magnets under the veneer, real wood veneer as well, it acts as a means to knock off some of the diffraction caused by a hard edge on a cabinet. And what that means for the listener is when you attach the grill covers on the inside edge, it absolutely helps with imaging. And it's uncanny. The AR6s, the imaging was without a doubt the first thing that I noticed. Flawless imaging. They just blend into the background and allow you to just sit there and immerse yourself in the music. Now, the same trick is applied to these. The imaging is phenomenal, but that actually is something quite synonymous with small loudspeakers anyway, I think. Now, what we've got here is a speaker that the height is less than an LS35A. They're actually more squat than an LS35A, so very small. They are quite deep, so they're not quite as small in overall dimensions as an LS35A, but they are very small. And one thing I absolutely love about these AR2s is they are mirror imaged. I think all speakers should be like that. If the driver is in an array, tweeter straight above the driver, mid-range or bass driver, that's fine. But if you've got one pair of speakers where the tweeters are both off to the same side, I can't help but wonder if that doesn't affect the imaging of the speaker somewhat. So you've got mirror imaged, tweeters both facing to the inside, grills both on the inside, ports on the outside. Now, being a ported system, these have a surprising amount of bass for such a small speaker. That's got to be down not only to a fantastic bass driver and a very well-designed crossover, but the depth of the cabinet, which features some intrinsic technology unique to Alchris Audio. And another thing I love about Alchris Audio is they don't try and hide any of that technology. If you follow them on their Facebook page, Alan will actually update the sort of manufacturing process of the speakers he's working on at that time. And sometimes that's even down to a sort of personal photo session of a pair of speakers he's building for a certain individual. So he can tag that individual on his Facebook page and you can physically see where in the process of manufacturing your own speakers are. And I thought that was a really, really nice personal touch. So if we move on to the sound of these loudspeakers. So they are voiced very similarly to the AR-6s. That's got that Alchris Audio in-house sound, which is very smooth. There's quite a lot of detail from that tweeter, which is a pretty high spec tweeter for a proper speaker of this price point. And that smooth characteristics lends to a speaker that you can listen to for many hours. Now, what most people get concerned about when it comes to a very small loudspeaker is what is the bass response like? Well, if I'm being completely honest, in this room, that size loudspeaker is probably a tad small. The AR-6 has worked a lot better in here, but physics rules, they're a bigger speaker, bigger driver, it is going to produce more bass. But the reason I think these are just a tad too small for this room is if you turn the volume up high, you can find that the loudspeaker will get a little bit, not congested, not confused, but a little bit overbeared, kind of frustrated almost with the amount of information that's trying to be transmitted from the loudspeaker. That's something the AR-6 didn't do. I could not push them too hard. Basically, the volume got so high in the room, I couldn't have listened to it at any serious length of time without either the neighbours complaining or me getting seriously, seriously tired of listening to music. You can't listen to it for that length of time. So my point being, the AR-6s, you could drive them really, really, really hard because the room suited those. In this room, if you push the volume too hard, it's not the speakers break up, they don't distort, they don't start to fall over, but it's almost too much for a room of this size. So I took them to the spare room upstairs, which is about half this size, and the same effect happened that I found with the AR-6s. You couldn't overrun them, you couldn't overdrive them. Basically, what happened is the music got far too loud for you to be able to comfortably sit there and listen to it. And I don't mean it was distorted, it was just too loud. So in the right environment, these are just like the AR-6s. They don't give up. You can really, really wind them up, which is great. That's what you want from a loudspeaker. The ability to really push it if you need to and not worry that something's just gonna give up. They won't do that. They are tremendous. But I do honestly think, and this is physics again, that a speaker of that size is going to work better in a room that suits a speaker of that size. So if you're in a medium-sized room, I would probably recommend the AR-6. If you're in a medium to large room, the AR-8 is definitely going to do a better job for you. But if you're in a flat or in a bed sit, or you've got a very small listening room, or you listen in a near field position, these AR-2s are absolutely phenomenal. So imaging, just like the AR-6s, probably actually even better than the AR-6 because it's a narrower baffle. Imaging was phenomenal. Bass response was absolutely brilliant for a speaker of that size. And detail, clarity was all spot on. Yet again, phenomenally designed crossover, very inert cabinet, no port chuffing. You were having no issues with any of the sometimes telltale signs of a front-ported or rear-ported speaker. No port chuffing at all. On the note of front-ported, they're not that fussy on placement either. Something I've found with rear-ported speakers is you really struggle to put them near a rear wall because obviously the ports are just firing straight into the wall and being reflected back. You don't have that problem with front ports. Although at the minute I've got those sitting probably a meter away from the back wall, I've only opted to do that because I don't really want to move my other speakers for now. But when I used them upstairs, they were fairly close to the rear wall and they sounded impressive. So if you put them in the right size room, they will absolutely fill that room full of sound. If you're sitting in the sweet spot, you've got a very, very nice sound field. The imaging, the sound stage is fantastic. In terms of scale, again, it's a small speaker, so you won't expect the kind of scale that you would get from a gigantic floor stander. But if you're in a really small room, you couldn't run a really big floor standing speaker because it would control the room. So in a nutshell, yet again, Alchris Audio have produced a phenomenal sounding pair of speakers with real wood veneers, the magnetic grill attachment on the side which helps with diffraction, high quality drivers, high quality components in the crossovers. These are phenomenal value for money. So to summarize, to tie this all up, if you've got a small to medium sized room, I would strongly recommend the AR-2s. If you wanted a second setup in a smaller room, these will be fantastic. Anybody out there who likes things like the original Proax, all the way up to the Proax Tablet 3s, these are very, very similar to that. They really are. They're fantastically well designed. I think they're slightly more modern sounding than maybe those old Proax, which I have had here. They will certainly cater for modern music in a better way. So I'm going to stop waffling. I'm going to do a couple of sound clips on these and we'll try a wide and varied style of music, several genres of music, very short clips, just to give you a rough idea of how these sound. Take care, guys. Catch up with you soon.
For fun.